My name is Kenneth Kent. Everybody just calls me Ken. I'm a professor in computer science from the University of New Brunswick in Canada. And I'm here on a visiting professor term as part of my sabbatical from the University of New Brunswick. And it's one that's been arranged for a while between myself and Professor Herpers. I once offered to give somebody a drive when they asked for it, is how it all started. So Professor Herpers, back in 2008, came to Canada for a summer school visit with a group of students. And he arranged to take the students for an outing to go see whales and visit the Bay of Fundy, where the largest tides in the world are. And he needed drivers to drive students. So I was a professor there at the time. I said, sure, I can offer to do that. And during the course of that, we chatted and he suggested sometime when I was available, I should come for a sabbatical. So in the fall of 2008, I came and visited and started doing some research with him, taught some students. And for the last 14 years, we've been going back and forth. I go to my rock concerts, students see me all the time and they know me. So yeah, the connection's been here a while now. And when I finished my first degree in computer science and I was thinking, okay, now I do my education degree. I told my dad and my dad said, don't do teaching. It's more about looking after kids in school now than actually teaching. So I didn't know what to do. And a friend of mine, his dad was a professor in sociology. And he told me, said, if you like teaching, go be a university prof. So I said, okay, I'll try that and see how it goes. So that's what I've been doing and I've been loving it ever since. The best part I like about teaching is getting to interact with the students and seeing the students excel and get to do the things that they like and getting to see them develop and choose their careers and go off and be successful. When they get to the end, then you can really look back and go, okay, I remember when you started and I remember where you are at the end, and you can go, okay, I made a difference. For me, it's just about creating the opportunities and then watching the students take advantage of it. I think good teaching comes down to engaging with the students and connecting with them. Anybody can go in and talk about a topic for any length of time if they prepare for it, but it's being able to actually get the students motivated and interested in the material, have that material absorbed by the students, and have the students want to actually interact, ask questions, learn more, ask even more questions about what they learn, and have that engagement where at the end of the class, they're not just, oh, thank God that's over. They want to keep learning and come back to the next class or learn more on their own. Well, the first one I had to figure out was probably Mitarbeiter, because every time I'd go to the mensa to get lunch, I'd have to try and negotiate as to whether I was paying as a guest, as a student, or as a Mitarbeiter. My interest is in working with computers to make them either go faster or to make them work more efficiently. So my work's in those areas, and I strongly believe that if I'm going to make an impact in those areas, then it has to be working with companies. Mm-hmm. So I do a lot of projects with companies where the outcomes of what myself and my students do directly goes into the company and then out into products in the world. So the German students I find are more familiar, they're more traditional with a hierarchy between the students and the professors. And so they're less inclined to go and ask questions or have casual conversations with professors or to question, I think you're wrong. Where Canadian students are more, no, you're wrong, sir, I'm right. I really enjoy working with the German students because they approach it definitely more professionally, but sometimes I like it a little bit more when they put their guard down and they go, okay, so let's work on this and figure it out mm-hmm. together, as opposed to trying to do it on their own. International exchanges are really beneficial in that they give both cultures an opportunity to see the differences that exist in how they go about approaching teaching, research, partnerships, interactions. So having international exchanges for professors as well as students is good. And because when I go back to Canada, I'll bring back with me my experiences from here, and I'll pass some of that on to my colleagues and to the students there. I tend to go with the flow and see what happens. But so far, it seems to be really good. I have my courses lined up, and I started those on Monday. I have high enrollment in two of them, which is pretty good. So normally my graduate course I teach to probably 10 or 15 students in Canada, where I have 60 registered in it here. So that's a great learning experience for me to be able to adapt to a different set of students and a larger set. I'm also planning on reaching out and talking to some of the people here in the entrepreneurship areas where they're looking at tech transfer to companies and startups, because I'm involved in some of that in Canada, and also working with some of the researchers here and talking about different projects they have and some of the things I'm working on and how we might be able to collaborate. So if I go with the flow and I'm open to seeing where things happen, then I'm sure I'll end up somewhere great. So general advice I'd have to any and every student would be, when you're doing your studies, take the time to explore and to experience as much as you can. Whether that's when you're picking your courses, trying a course that you're not sure you may or may not like, or an area you may or may not like. Whether that's getting the chance to do an exchange term at another university or in another country, or at an internship with a company. Now's the time where you have the greatest flexibility in your life to be able to take advantage of those opportunities, try them, see what you learn. Sometimes you learn a lot from knowing, I don't like this, more so than you learn that, oh, I like that. So take advantage of those opportunities, because later on you'll regret if you didn't. Several of my students have always said to me they wanted to be me, so I that's a hard one. I guess if you wanted to go on the career path that I went on, my suggestion would be to work hard and take advantage of the opportunities that come, and go with the flow and be open to where it ends up bringing you. I'm just very happy to be here, thankful to the DAAD for providing the opportunity, and the same thing for the Hochschule Bonrhein-Sieg, particularly Mr. Boda, Mr. Heiden, and Mr. Herpers, and Frau Kutz, who helped a lot in terms of putting together the application and supporting it.